Good afternoon, students. I am your social science teacher, Malvika Daniel, and today we will study civics for class 7th. The topic we'll start from is the first chapter, that is on equality. Before starting the chapter, I would please request all of you to grab a copy and a pen and write down everything important that we discussed today. The topics that we will cover today in the lesson are equal right to vote. Under that, we will study universal adult franchise. Then, we'll study other kinds of equality. Under that, we'll study about caste system and Dalits. The third topic will be recognizing dignity. And the fourth topic, equality in Indian democracy. So, let's start. As we know that India is a democracy. In a democratic government, people participate in elections. They solve the conflict. Then there is equality and justice for all. In today's chapter, we will focus on equality and why it is important for a democracy. We will study about equal right to vote. Children, you must have studied about the topic universal adult franchise in your previous classes. Do you know what it means? It means that in a democratic country like India, all the adults are above the age of 18 years, no matter of what religion they profess, or what caste they belong to, or how much education they have had, or what social strata of the society they belong, or whether they are rich or poor, they are allowed to vote. And this is called universal adult franchise. There are other inequality that exist, that is the caste system. You must have also studied about this in your history in class 6th. There are four classes, as we know, the Brahmins, who were the teachers, then there was the Kshatriyas, who were the warriors, then there were Vaishyas, who were merchants and traders, and lastly there were Shudras, who used to do menial works or get jobs done for the other three classes. The Dalits also belong to the lower classes of society. As we know that the caste system is very much prevalent in rural areas. So, who are the Dalits? Dalit was a term that was used by the lower classes to address themselves. So, they themselves used to call them as Dalit. Dalit meant being broken. Why? Because they were continuously discriminated. In your book, we have two stories about people who faced discrimination. One is about Om Prakash Valmiki, who was a Dalit, and other is about Ansaris, who felt that they were discriminated because of the religion they followed. So let's begin with the stories. Om Prakash Valmiki is a Dalit writer, but when he was a child, and he was in a school, he was made to sit away from other students. He was made to sit at the door, and then he also used to get picked by other students. Why? Because he was a Dalit. When he was in class 4, his teachers asked him to sweep the entire floor and the playground, clean the entire playground. Why? Because he belonged to a lower class of Dalit. And always he used to be harassed by other students and the teachers. Once he was cleaning the playground and his father was passing by from the school, and his father saw him sweeping the floor. He was so furious because of the unequal treatment his son got. His son was made to feel that he was less than equal compared with the rest of the students. He was furious at the teachers and even later confronted the teachers and told them that his son has come here to study and not to clean, and there will be more people like his son that will come and study. The next story we hear is about Ansaris. The Ansaris were trying to find some apartment to live in the city, and they had money to pay for the apartment. So they hired one property dealer, and along with him, they started searching for the flat they wanted to live in. And finally, after a couple of apartments they saw, they really liked one flat and they contacted the landlady. But the landlady refused to give them the flat. On this excuse she gave, that because they ate meat and rest of the people in the building were vegetarians. This was, however, not the case, because they could smell fish that was being cooked in the neighborhood. This was not the only time they got discriminated because of the religion. Couple of other times also they faced the same excuse. Finally, the property dealer asked them to change their name from Ansaris to Mr. and Mrs. Kumar. The Ansaris refused to do so. And in the end, after a month or so, they finally found a flat, and even the landlady agreed to give them rent. So what we can see? We can see that both Om Prakash Valmiki and the Ansaris faced discrimination because, one, for the caste they were born to, and second, for the religion they had. The next topic that we will study today is equality in Indian democracy. So let's start by defining what is constitution. As you know, that it is a document that lays down the rule for and regulations for people and the government in a country to follow. Both the people and the country, they need to follow these basic rules and regulations. So the Indian constitution recognizes every person as equal. This means that every individual in the country, including male and female, or people from all castes, religion, or tribes, and educational and economic backgrounds are regarded as equal. There are various provisions in the Constitution on giving recognition to equality. The first one is that every person is equal before law. This means that no matter what a person may be, that person may be the president, the prime minister, or maybe an actor or a sportsperson, or even somebody like a domestic servant or a teacher, a doctor, all are equal. No person can be discriminated against on the basis of their religion, race, caste, place of birth, or whether they are female or male. As we can see in point number 2, that the Ansaris faced discrimination because they followed a particular religion. And Valmiki, Om Prakash Valmiki, faced discrimination because he belonged from a particular caste. But this is not the case. People are equal according to the law. The third topic is that every person has access to all the public places, including the playground, hotels, shops, markets. All people can use public available wells, roads, and bathing ghats. That is, that you cannot ask somebody or refuse somebody to enter a particular place. Like in the previous years, we must have heard about women not being allowed to enter into a temple, or the lower classes being refused to drink from the same well with the upper castes. So we can say that untouchability has been abolished.